Out front next, breaking news, growing questions over what John Kelly knew and when. How did top White House aide Rob Porter keep his job despite months of damning evidence of domestic abuse? And one woman at the center of the controversy. She dated Porter and helped craft the White House defense of him. Hope Hicks. Plus more breaking news. A government shutdown now likely in just 5 hours. Let's go out front. And good evening, I'm Erin Burnett. Out front tonight, domestic abuse. The White House Chief of Staff John Kelly and senior Trump aides knew early last fall that former White House Staff Secretary Rob Porter was accused of domestic abuse by both his ex-wives. But the White House today tried to muddy the timeline. Fully aware. It's a strange term if you already knew about allegations of domestic abuse. I mean, what John Kelly learned yesterday that he didn't know about months ago is not at all clear right now. Now, remember, both of Porter's ex-wives told FBI investigators very damning stories. And there was a third woman, a girlfriend who lived with Porter while he worked at the White House, who reached out to Porter's ex-wives to talk about the abuse she said she was enduring. And according to Politico, she called the White House herself directly, reported the abuse to the general counsel, Don McGahn. Despite all this, three women, two ex-wives and a live-in girlfriend, Porter remained on the job, privy to the United States' most sensitive information. That is, until the Daily Mail did Porter resign. And today, the White House Deputy Press Secretary Raj Shah took the podium to try to take on damage control. Shah was repeatedly asked why the White House and John Kelly kept Porter on for so long in the face of the allegations, especially fighting back after the story blew up in the Daily Mail. It wasn't until 9:30 last night, a full 25 hours after that Daily Mail story was first published, 13 hours after the photo of Colby Holderness's black eye became public, which, by the way, she'd shared with the FBI over a year ago, that Kelly changed his tune. He then says, quote, "Backed by new allegations. The problem is there wasn't anything new here. Kelly knew about allegations of domestic abuse for months. The Daily Mail then reported them. Kelly defended Porter. The Daily Mail added a picture. Kelly defended Porter again. And then he put out a new statement. And now they're saying the picture changed things." The context here matters, too, because the reality of it is this White House has a long and consistent history in dealing with allegations of sexual abuse. Remember Roy Moore, the Alabama GOP Senate candidate, 2 weeks after the first public allegations against Moore by four women who charged he sexually abused them when they were in their teens, Trump said this. And over the decades, at least 15 women have accused Trump himself of sexual misconduct. The response from Trump and his aides is always the same. It's all lies in this. So if you know there's claims of domestic abuse from both of someone's ex-wives, a person who's 40 with two ex-wives, their live-in girlfriend calls the White House general counsel to talk about her allegations of domestic abuse, and nobody did anything about it. And then when it broke in the press, which is the only reason it would have ever come out, they defend him.
Sure. And that's extremely troubling. They say that classified information. We don't need to know all the details. We don't need a video. We don't need pictures. Reason enough is someone that is accused by multiple.
They got in their eyes.
And they let that overshadow their good judgment on taking the appropriate steps to do away with someone that has these serious allegations against them. Domestic abuse.
Gloria, I think what's so shocking about this is the point Alice raises. To imply you're not fully aware. It is pretty stunning when you just think about the whole situation here. In any situation, why, when you have the most important women in someone's life, they're all coming forward and saying the same thing, that anybody would buy that. Well, they're just scorned or they're jealous or whatever it might have been. I mean, it's again, it defies reason. I want to play a little bit more of what Jenny Willoughby, Porter's second ex-wife, said to the Washington Post about what happened. Here she is. Finds a protective order and has the police come to their home after an issue of domestic abuse. These are very serious things.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Well, I understand that John Kelly is Rob Porter's.
Did know they were of the domestic abuse.
But he has the right to look at the FBI file, which means that he didn't believe the women.
And the FBI file, by the way, would have had all these details from the interviews. The interviews were done. The pictures had been produced. I mean, I'm just saying the files would have had details.
And what's really sad about this is that, given all the Me Too movement involved, to think that in the fall of last year, General Kelly didn't.
Dr. Jekyll and Mr. Hyde, clearly he has a pattern of behavior that is extremely contradictory to how he is during the day. Mm-hmm. He is vulnerable for anyone that wants to find someone in the government that can get secret information. If he is one person by day and another person by night, he can be very easily compromised.
Or blackmailed, right?
Certainly.
We know this information. We're going to put this information out publicly about what happened. And you know, I mean, I guess that. Alice, what about the point, though, that seems so troubling here? They seem to believe Rob Porter, not all the women that he has been involved with in a serious way in his life. Don't believe any of the president's accusers. Believe Roy Moore and none of his accusers. It's consistent. And it's not just the president. It's the chief of staff. It's his female press secretary. It's everybody.
That's disturbing. It's a pattern of behavior for at least for 24 hours. That was the wrong impression. Mm-hmm. And also, let me just say this about Hope Hicks. She can date whoever she wants to. She's free to do that. But when she's involved in drafting a statement, it's her personal business. But on a professional level, from a communication standpoint, you should recuse yourself 100% from drafting a character statement about someone you're romantically involved in.
Right, especially. Well, go ahead, Gloria.
And Aaron, you know,
this is just the latest controversy involving John Kelly. Is Trump's chief of staff going to leave? Plus, breaking news, drama on Capitol Hill, a government shutdown about 5 hours away, less than that. It's likely right now. The White House has just told agencies to prepare now for a shutdown. And the White House laughing off some stunning claims by a former employee. Breaking news, the knives now out for John Kelly. Sources telling CNN the president's chief of staff is facing blowback after his blunder protecting the accused wife abuser, Rob Porter. This is not Kelly's first brush with controversy this week. Just a few days ago, he bashed some immigrants as, quote, too lazy to get off their asses. A few weeks ago, he contradicted the president on his key immigration campaign promises as well. The White House tonight says the president retains full confidence in Kelly. What do you think?
I think he's got to go, actually, after this. I don't know that he will go. You know, before Corey Lewandowski was accused, Steve Bannon was accused. So I understand why John Kelly might have thought this is not a firing offense, but it is a firing offense. Now that we know everything, this man did not have a full security clearance, and he is presumably handling some incredibly classified important information as he's presenting things to the president. He's the man who brings in the stack of papers that the president usually doesn't read, but he has access to
all of it. Pretty much
so
every
that,
piece
I mean,
of paper.
Leave aside the women, which I can't and which we shouldn't, but even leaving that aside, the notion that this man was allowed to handle these papers without a full security clearance, that bells didn't go off, it's a firing offense.
And Steve, you know, just to repeat here, sources say so much interest in that, but I want to start by asking this whole issue of security clearances.
Yeah.
I know it can take a while to get approval. Rob Porter had gone a year. The FBI had raised red flags. We knew that Kelly was aware of at least some of them. Rob Porter's not the only one in the White House working on an interim a year where that would indicate clearly there's some sort of question marks at least. Jared Kushner is another.
Correct.
How serious is that?
Well, the dirty little secret about security clearances is...
If you have those patrons and it's been a year, is that an extra sign of concern? The FBI can't get to yes after a year when your patron is the chief of staff of the president.
But it's a sign that the system is not working. During that year, these... So if you can't figure out within a year whether someone is fit to do that, you know, that's too much time.
You have your answer.
Correct.
I think this is one of those cases where you have your answer.
Correct.
So obviously a lot of questions about Jared Kushner then to come because that one's still out there pending. All right, Patty Hearst.
Yes.
So this is something you are passionate about.
I am.
You know more about than anybody. People are so fascinated by it. The FBI says this case is one of the strangest in its history. February 1974.
The mystery. Was she really a member of the SLA? Did she really change her mind? Or was she coerced? Was she forced, brainwashed? And that debate continues to this day. And that debate is aired out in, you know, very interesting way in this documentary.
Well, in a way that no one else can do because you know so much about this. So without asking him which of those will
be... I wrote a book about this,
yes.
American Heiress.
So his conclusions as to her role, don't miss it. You'll see it. The radical story of Patty. Tonight, Omarosa is back. And the White House is playing a key role because she's speaking out about her role next to the president for so many months. Here's Jeannie Moos. Thanks for joining us. Don't forget you can watch Out Front anytime, anywhere. You just have to go to CNN Go. AC 360 begins right now.